briefly turn back to 1787. September 17th, Constitution Hall, the city of Philadelphia. And 55 men were meeting there to rewrite the Articles of Confederation. As you will recall, after the colonists won their independence from Great Britain in 1783, the founding fathers created a document to govern, and it was called the Articles of Confederation. A confederation is a loose organization, and the Articles of Confederation were that. The new state did not want to give up much of their power to a central government. And so they created a legislature, but there was no judiciary and no executive branch. There was no power to tax, and without the power to tax, it's very hard to carry on the affairs of government. And so the founding fathers decided, through conversation, that they really needed to redraft the document under which they governed. And George Washington was one of the leading people who organized the movement to meet in Philadelphia. He and other Virginians in particular, I do want to point out that Virginia had a leading role in all this, were very active in promoting the redrafting of the Articles. And James Madison, another Virginian, was the primary writer of the new Constitution as we know it today. He had been friends with Thomas Jefferson and knew his thoughts as well. So together, the men, they didn't always agree, but they worked it out over the summer, and so on September 17th, they finished their work.
Thank you. be able to present the proclamation to the Daughters of American Revolution and for acknowledging Constitution Week and then formally signing the proclamation. So let me present it first, then I'll sign it, and the students observe and do some photo ops, and then present it. And the Constitution, the proclamation reads as follows. Whereas in March 1785, commissioners from Maryland and Virginia met in Alexandria and later at Mount Vernon at the request of George Washington in an effort to settle issues relating to trade and navigation of the Potomac River. And let me just pause for a second, look at the picture off to my left. You guys know who that is? George Washington. Do you know what role George Washington had in the city of Alexandria? He was the first president of the nation, but what else? George Washington. Yeah, Continental Army, but George Washington came to Alexandria as a young teen, pretty much maybe just a few years older than you guys, and but he was instrumental, one, in helping to organize the city to become, the town, to be incorporated, to become what we are today. He actually suggested the name for the city. It was named after a Scottish merchant by the name of John Alexander, who came here as well, found this place, loved it, stayed, opened up businesses, and George Washington suggested to the rest of the citizens, let's name it Alexandria after John Alexander. And then he also became the fifth mayor of the city, back way back when. And so me, as a product of the public, of the city of Alexandria and the public schools, I'm honored to have followed George Washington's footsteps in becoming also a mayor. Who knows, maybe someday I'll become president. whereas these meetings subsequent led to the development of the Constitutional Convention in Philadelphia in 1787, and whereas our founding fathers, in order to secure the blessings of liberty for themselves and their prosperity, did ordain and establish a constitution for the United States of America, and whereas it is of greatest importance that all citizens fully understand the provisions and principles contained in the Constitution in order to support, preserve, and defend it against encroachment. And whereas 227th anniversary of the signing of the Constitution provides a historic opportunity for all Americans to learn about and recall achievements of our founders and to reflect on the rights and privileges of citizenship, as well as its attendant responsibilities. And whereas the independence guaranteed to the American people by the Constitution should be celebrated by appropriate ceremonies and activities during Constitution Week, September 17th through the 23rd, 2014, as designated by proclamation of the President of the United States of America in accordance with Public Law 915. Now, therefore, I, William D. Euille, the Mayor of the City of Alexandria, Virginia, and on behalf of the Alexandria City Council, do hereby proclaim the week of September 17th through 23rd, 2014, as Constitution Week in the City of Alexandria, and urge all citizens to pay special attention during that week to our federal Constitution and the advantage of American citizenship, and witness whereof I have herein to set my hand and cause a seal of the City of Alexandria to be fixed this the 15th day of September 2014.
The kids are here from Jefferson-Houston and really from different schools all over Alexandria to celebrate the importance of Constitution Day. It's truly the bedrock of everything that we do. And as our students get ready to transition to the next phase of life, whether it's to high school, like our students at Jefferson-Houston, or from high school to college, or into the life of the world we live in, it's important that they know those fundamental bedrock principles that makes America the shining beacon on a hill that it always has been and always will be.
I'm so pleased that the students are here to experience this and various age groups too, because history is important and it is important for them to understand how our government works and to meet some local government officials and know that they have access as citizens to the history here in Alexandria.